coming up on one of the entrances of the palace, which we're still in the, well, not we there, the Kekchi, from the communities. We have trained under the best experts, the local people, all the restoration, no Italian artistry, done by the local people, and they do a fabulous job. But this thing is, still doesn't have its plaster over it. And we put this tin roof to protect it. But the two big storms, the same one that's destroyed most of the camp, wrecked this roof. And you can see that we have a lot of the entrance stairway. A lot of the entrance stairway here is covered in plastic. And we have, again, we have these signs, these rotolos in English, Spanish, with a painting by the famous Huicho, a painting here of what it looked like then. We're right here. This is one of the main entrances into the royal palace, which continues way over that way. But just this part of it, you see, you go in through here, a couple of chambers, presentation chambers, and then you go down into a courtyard with a hieroglyphic staircase. But most, for most of the people, it ended here. And they have the trip. They weren't allowed in the palace. You had to be somebody special to get to here. But if you made it to here, we put this wooden stairway for the time. The time being a wooden stairway to help preserve as we're restoring. This looks like just like the beautiful restored ruins of Tikal and so on, but we're not finished restoring it. So people think this is some kind of odd architecture. It's the normal stuff, but without the plaster coating. And you can see that most of the visitors, the ones that came here were important, that got to this point were important people, but even for 90% of them, trip ended here, and you had this reception platform here, where some official sat and would deal with disputes, provide rituals and whatever else is needed. You have these spaced along the wall of this part of the palace, and that's where he would sit. And to show you how much, Benaka, how much it was covered with plaster, you see here preserved some of the plaster. And that's how thick it was. We have to do that to the whole thing, which continues that way. Show him over there, the part that we had to put plastic sheets over because the roof collapsed in the storm. Another interesting thing you see here, over here, is that the entrance, all of the most important entrances, the royal buildings, were buried under hundreds of tons of stone and clay. They buried them. They do this at Maya sites, but here was the most spectacular termination ritual, as they say. They not only killed the king and the queen and all the nobility and a lot of soldiers, they also desacralized and ritually killed everything. They toppled. These things, these rooms were originally 9 meters tall. Ridiculous. Huge. That's over 30 feet. And the whole top half was knocked off. And we've been able to restore, maybe that's maybe two-thirds of it, 60% of it. And the part that went up was covered with enormous stucco sculptures, larger than life size, portraits. Different portraits in front of each audience chamber. And we assume that those were various nobles. In this period, just before the collapse, they had divided up the power a lot. The kings were losing their power. And the nobles, here noble merchants, because they have little palaces by the ports, were controlling more and more and more. And here you see one of the typical audience chambers. Which, again, these, you can't live in these rooms. They're not made to live in. They're sealed off. It would have gone up from here. She was another 5 or 6 meters. Over this, these giant plaster sculptures. We know this because they fell, and then when they buried the whole place under all this rubble, the entrance, these were all preserved. And we have giant, I mean, you know, they're at least they're 3.5 meters tall, like 10 feet high sculptures, full round faces and seated kings or seated nobles with stuff in between. And We know that these were the reception chambers. 90% of the palace at the end were reception chambers for officials, nobles, and probably the merchants, whose palaces you see at each port. They had their offices here. This is an office. You see the bench that they would sit on. It's not like your normal Maya benches. You can't sleep on that. And the room's sealed off and has no privacy. It has this open side. There are definitely reception chambers. By the end, as the economy changed, the merchants became more and more powerful, and this became an office building for them. And the giant stuccos, each one has a face that the art historians all have said these are portraits. But we also have stuccos further in that are portraits of the king. These are not the king. And they're beautiful with obsidian eyes and everything. They're in the museum, the National Museum, and also they travel all over Europe and the States sometimes in exhibits. But so each of these chambers, and they're all around the outside of the palace where the people who couldn't get in, high, you know, caciques, chiefs or something from the area, not, you know, high officials, but not the highest. This would be the end of the story for them. And then here, there are only two of these that go all the way through. And they have a room. It was covered with plastic, and we have pieces of the murals. It was all covered with paintings, again, going up another 5, 6 feet, 7 at least, well, up to where the tin roof is. And you can see there was a curtain here, we know from the curtain holes. And this was a room, they would do rituals and purify you. I've been through this with the modern Maya, and you just about asphyxiate from the smoke and being hit by leaves. I require a lot of purification, apparently. But you can see the thick plaster that covered everything, and then traces of the paint. And then if you were cool, you'd get through here. If you were really important, you'd get through here, where there is a reception courtyard where they would do dances and so on with the elites. We see it on the painted pots. And you can see, again, the thick plaster covering. We haven't restored any of that. You can see traces of the paint. There's actually, with infrared, you can see a noble sitting there with a big headdress. And this was all painted.
Yeah, los arqueólogos se van, Arthur.
¿Cómo?
Los arqueólogos ya se van.
No, ya me lo están diciendo.